Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 21st April 2018. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, a company based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company Superior Profit, or more importantly, how it may help in your trading, you may click on the About Us menu on our website superiorprofit.co. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As usual, we will look at oil and gold, the commodities that tend to impact related stocks. A rising tide lifts all or many boats. In case of the ocean, all boats, but in case of the stock market, many boats. Therefore, we keep an eye on broad market using market breadth of NASDAQ and NYSE, and also the technical analysis of four broad market ETFs. That helps us understand which direction the market is going and try to align our trades with that direction. Other than the market, we also like to align our trades with industry's strength or weakness that we can identify from QH industry scorecard and heat map. We'll do the same today. Along the way, we may go through some of the trade examples shared in our traders forum and look for potential trades for the coming week. In the last two market roundups, we saw it was not easy to find optimal trade opportunities. That continues to be the case this week as well. Still, we'll see if we can find some setups that are either ready or going to be ready probably next week. That was the last slide of the presentation. Let's move to live system. We start our commodity study using oil. We are looking at the oil ETF USO using weekly backdrop template and daily hop on template. Together we call this at a glance template because it helps us decide if there is a low risk entry opportunity at the right edge of the chart, usually in few seconds. Last week, oil had gone up, hit the upper boundary, pulled back little bit, and then went up again. At the time of the pullback, it didn't give us any long entry opportunity because there was a very large gap up between the yellow candle and the next cyan candle. If the cyan candle had come close to the value area, then it would give us a go with flow long trade opportunity, but that didn't come because of the gap up. On Thursday and Friday, price pulled back little bit. It is very close to the upper boundary, so we are not going to try any long trade right now, and it is clearly bullish in the daily chart. So we are not going to try any short as well. There is no swing trade opportunity in oil right now. What about gold? Last week, looking at the weekly candle shape, I had mentioned that it was better to stay away from any long trade in gold. That analysis proved accurate. This week, if we look at the daily chart from the right side, we can see it didn't go anywhere, simply moved around the same price level that had been the center for several past weeks. It is not moving with any direction, neither is it giving any easy to take sideways market box trade opportunity. It is moving somewhat random manner, and there are multiple gap ups and gap downs. This was a gap up day from where price fell down, and Friday was a gap down day. There is no swing trade opportunity in gold also, and it may take a while looking at the current chart before we get a low risk swing trade opportunity in gold. Gold is moving sideways, however the gold miners were getting stronger and we could take some profitable trades in some gold miners. We had discussed these two stocks earlier, Royal Gold and Newmont Mining. Both of them had gone up. Later on during industry analysis, we will see that it is probably time to book profit in those two gold mining stocks. We will look at that when we study the decelerating industries. Let's now move to broad market analysis. Every week we study market breadth using NASDAQ Composite Index and NYSE Composite Index, both using weekly charts. Because this study is using composite indices and weekly charts, it is to be used for longer term investment decisions, not so much for swing trading and certainly not for day trading. Last week, NASDAQ and NYSE had both gone up. However, the new high low for both were practically unchanged, and advanced decline, up down volume for both. Though they recovered, they were far from zero. They ended in the negative 1 week ago. This week, on a closing basis, both NASDAQ and NYSE went up. However, new high low for both of them declined, and the other four internals declined as well. Here we have a case where price went up, but the internals, first weekend, 1 week ago, and this week decline. This is showing an under the hood picture that is bearish, though the markets went up. If we look at the candles shapes, then both NASDAQ and NYSE candle shapes are pretty bearish. If we combine the candle shape and the internals, we have to conclude that the market is not bullish at present. We cannot say it is bearish because on closing basis price went higher. However, the internals are showing that more stocks are declining. Advanced decline went down. They are declining with higher volume. Up-down volume went down. And even the new high lows decline, meaning more stocks are going to the extremes, lower side, and not so many stocks are going up to the highest side anymore. This is neutral to bearish picture on the overall market. Let's see what is the picture we see from the market ETF study. We are looking at SPY using at a glance template. In the daily chart, SPY is bound by resistance memory at the top and support memory at the bottom. It's a triangle pattern, somewhat wide triangle pattern, and price is right in the middle of the triangle pattern. Because it is in the middle of the triangle pattern, this is not an area where optimal swing trade opportunities will come. They will come either at the upper extreme or at the lower extreme. There is no swing trade opportunity in SPY right now. The weekly is showing that the candle shape is very bearish, similar to NYSE broad index. However, we will not have any low risk entry opportunity until price either reverses from the daily memories or breaks out of the memories and then gives us a swing low. We have to wait patiently for that to come. It may not come in next few days. It will probably take 1 week or more before we have clarity on the direction on SPY. QQQ has a very similar picture like SPY. In the weekly, the shape is showing that the bears are in control, at least in the later part of the week. That is what resulted in the upper tail. Here we don't have any resistance memory at the top, only support memory at the bottom. So based on the technical charts, QQQ is stronger than SPY. As it is not inside any triangle pattern, in case QQQ goes up next week and gives us a cyan color candle, then it may give us a go with flow long trade opportunity. Looking at the technical charts, if we have to take a long opportunity next week in one of these two ETFs, we will choose QQQ over SPY. There is no likely short swing trade opportunity that we are expecting next week in QQQ. DIA, it is similar to SPY but weaker than SPY. It is also inside a triangle pattern in daily chart and it has a memory resistance in the weekly chart. This week's candle shape is bearish, color is still cyan in weekly, bullish. That was the same in SPY QQQ as well. As it is inside triangle pattern in daily, we are not going to try any swing trade in DIA right now. IWM, Russell 2000 ETF. This ETF had been the strongest in past several weeks. We can see that from the weekly chart relative performance line tilting up. This week IWM also has a bearish shape candle in the weekly chart. However, not as bearish as the other three ETFs. In daily chart, 1 week ago we had discussed that this was the only ETF that could close above the yellow direction line. That yellow direction line was never breached. From there, price went up and last 2 days it pulled back little bit. If it goes up from here and gives a cyan color candle, then we'll have a go with flow long trade opportunity in IWM as well. And that would in fact be a better opportunity than to take long in QQQ. After analyzing all the four ETFs, if we have to take any long trade next week, then we would take that in IWM. On the short side, there doesn't seem to be any likely opportunity right now. If we combine the broad market breadth, which is showing that under the hood more stocks are going down and they are going down with higher volume, though the indices are going up, is not giving much confidence to take longs. At the same time, when we look at the ETFs, the market ETFs, none of them are giving long opportunities right now, but none of them are giving any short opportunity as well. In fact, next week, if the market goes up, then two of the ETFs will give low risk long opportunities, IWM and QQQ, whereas we don't expect to have any low risk short opportunity next week. So we cannot say it is very bearish as well. When the market ETFs don't give any short opportunity, many stocks may also not give any short opportunity. Like in past several weeks, it may be better to stay away from the market. And if you want to trade, you may take trades in some stocks which are at the extremes, that is swing lows or swing highs and giving appropriate low risk opportunities. We had some opportunities in the market this week also, and next week we may find them again. We'll try to locate some of them from the sector and industry analysis. Let's do that now. Every week we study 11 sectors across 3 review periods. Red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week before the red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks before the green bar. Together they constitute 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar to the right of the zero line indicates sector went up, and any bar to the left of the zero line indicates the sector went down. Several weeks in the past we had seen massive flip-flop, all sectors going up 1 week, all sectors going down next week. That didn't happen last week, and that didn't happen this week as well. This week 7 sectors went up and 4 went down. Overall, that is bullish. Though the broad market breadth and ETFs were not showing in a bullish picture, at the higher level, at sector level at least, we see that sectors overall are more bullish than bearish. That is a bit contrasting or contradicting pictures we are getting from different analysis. Another reason we may stay away from the market. Materials went up by higher percentage 1 week ago than this week. Same is true for healthcare, energy. Overall, the strength of up moves declined from the previous week. For 2 successive weeks, sector move is mixed, some sectors up and some down. Though more sectors went up than down, over 1 month, only 3 sectors are up. That are utilities went up by 1.1%, materials by 1.2%, and energy, the biggest gainer of last 1 month, went up by 9.7%. In the same period, oil went up by 7.3%. So energy stocks went up by higher percentage than oil. Oil and energy stocks had been the best performers of past few weeks. However, it is showing deceleration in industry rotation over all the review periods, 5 days, 2 days and 1 day. This widespread deceleration is indicating that it may be good idea to book profit in energy stocks long position, or at minimum protect profit with stop using protection signal. We'll soon look at QH and study how the energy industries are decelerating, and then look at some of the energy stocks that we had identified earlier for possible long trades and see where to protect profit in them right now. Information technology had a very large gain 1 week ago, and this week it ended with a small loss. In the last market roundup, I had mentioned that caution was warranted in information technology sector, though it had gone up and was the second best performer. That was accurate analysis, as this sector reversed from a substantial gain to a small loss in spite of the overall market going up. You may protect profit in long stocks and look for low risk shorts in this sector. Actually, this is last week's sector performance analysis, where I had mentioned that though Infotech reversed, at that time it was still down by more than 5% over 1 month period, and it was not easy at that time to identify low risk long opportunities. That led me to say that we had to be cautious and not take many longs in Infotech. That analysis was accurate, and anybody could do that analysis using the Q systems. They would come to the same conclusion that though the sector had gone up, there were no low risk long trades, and that meant that caution was warranted. The sector went down, and later on during industry analysis we'll see several of the worst performers are in Infotech sector, again showing that it is not time to take new long positions in Infotech, rather one may look for potential shorts. Financials, this sector has gone up for two successive weeks. Q sector and industry rotation tables are showing acceleration among several financial industries. Using QH, we can see the strength coming back into financials, and we may start looking for longs in this sector. Let's go to QH and see how the sector's strengths are moving, and also drill down to the energy industries and finance industries. Every time we open QH, it analyzes 11 sectors and more than 170 industries across 12 monthly periods, and more frequently over recent periods of 10 days, 5 days, 2 days and 1 day. Let's look at the sector panel. For each of the review periods, we can sort from smallest to largest. What QH does is assign the score of 1 to the worst performing item. So consumer staples is the worst performer for this week, that is 5 trading days, and a large number to the best performer. Energy continues to be the best performer this week as well. It had been the best performer for several periods now. QH also assigns a color gradient, magenta to the worst performer, cyan to the best performer. That gives us a scorecard and heat map that instantly tells us which sector is strong, energy, which one is weak, consumer staples, and in addition tells us which ones are changing strength from weakness to strength. Not many, right? Maybe consumer discretionary. But consumer discretionary has a checkered pattern, cyan, magenta and cyan again. It is moving in an indecisive fashion. The ones that were strong for a while, energy and industrials, are strong, and the ones that were weak for a while, consumer staples, real estate, are weak now also. If we drill down into the energy industries, we can click on the drill down button, go to the industry panel. Here, for all the energy industries, we see they had been strong for several periods. However, looking at the pace columns, 5 days, 2 days and 1 day pace columns, we see a lot of magenta colors. They show up in magenta color when the industries are decelerating. That is the reason if we have long profitable stock positions in these energy industries, it may be good idea to book some profit and protect profit using stops. On the other hand, if we drill down into financials industries, we can see that some of the financials industries, consumer finance, investment brokerage, multi-line insurance, asset management, several of them are improving in strength. Multi-line insurance is one that was weak for long time. The same is true for life and health insurance. Both are related to insurance. It seems that insurance related stocks are gaining in strength. They were weak for a long time. This leads us to analyze more into these industries and look for potential longs. Those may be good long term investment opportunities or also swing trade long opportunities. You may drill down into these industries and see if such low risk opportunities exist. These are the 10 best performing industries of this week. Best performing industries gained by between 3.8% to 6.5%. Sizable gains. However, later we'll see that the declining industries went down by much bigger percentages. Three of the best performing industries are in energy sector and other three are in consumer discretionary. All but one, that is hotel, resorts and cruise lines, had gained in the previous week as well. So nine of the best performing industries are continuing their upward momentum from the previous week. This is not so bearish. Remember, in earlier market roundups, when the week was bearish, we had difficulty finding 10 best performing industries that actually went up. That is not the case. That is not the case this week, and that was not the case in the previous week as well. Nine of the best performers of this week are continuing their up move from the previous week. So market is certainly not that bearish. Industrial conglomerates is one of the best performers, and this stock, General Electric, broke its long downtrend after displaying bullish headwind at the very bottom. Once again, the bullish headwind signal could catch the very bottom of the stock. You may keep an eye on this stock for potential buy opportunity. It is currently optimally valued. Hotels, resorts and cruise lines went up this way. Marriott, the hotel chain, has one of the best earnings growth in this industry. The daily chart broke out of memory resistance. You may look for potential long if the stock and its industry continues to be strong in the next week. Let's look at industrial conglomerates and hotel, resort and cruise lines and drill down to the General Electric stock and Marriott. Look at their fundamentals and then look at their technicals. In QH, to find the best performing industries, we can sort over the primary period 5 days, largest to smallest. That will bring the best performing industries to the top. Hotel, resorts and cruise lines. This industry was magenta in recent period. So it was relatively weak, and over 10 days and over 5 days, it has gained score sharply. It has turned bullish, that we know from the 5-day score being cyan and it has accelerated, that we know from the past 5 days score being cyan as well. Let's look at the stocks in this industry. We could click the drill down button to drill down into the stocks in real time. For saving time, we will use the offline Q scorecard. This is Q scorecard. Here we have statistics, fundamental statistics on 2500 liquid stocks for the USA market. Using the industry column, we can look for stocks in hotel, resorts and cruise lines. We can sort them over relative value column that will show which ones are the strongest. The strongest stocks in terms of valuation come in cyan color. The overvalued stocks come in magenta color. Marriott. Where is Marriott? Marriott is overvalued. We know that from the magenta color. That is fine. If its earnings growth is strong, then we can still say that the stock is strong fundamentally in terms of growth. We can say a stock is fundamentally strong either in terms of valuation or growth, not usually both together. That is the common scenario. In this case, we see Marriott is not optimally valued, but it has good growth. We can know more about the growth from the growth panel. Here we can see from the growth panel, Marriott has positive growth for earnings over all the past 5 years. Positive revenue growth for all the 5 years as well, and recent year EPS and revenue growth has accelerated. They have turned from dark green to bright green, showing the growth has accelerated. If we look at recent most quarter, then we see earnings has accelerated growth as well. In the recent most quarter, it turned from dark green to bright green. Revenue growth decelerated a little bit, still it is positive in green color. Overall, we can see Marriott has one of the best growth across this long period from current quarter till last 5 years. When we buy stocks, we like to buy the stocks that are strongest, either in terms of valuation or growth. Marriott seems to be one that is strongest in terms of growth. Let's look at its technical charts to see if it can give us a possible long trade opportunity. We are looking at Marriott using Hopon template. Earlier it had gone up very strongly. At the top it displayed a bearish headwind signal at the very top that led to the stock's decline, and now several days ago it displayed a bullish headwind. Since then the stock is gradually moving up. It had multiple memory resistance lines as of this day's candle, that is Tuesday of this week. All the memory resistance lines are broken, and as of Friday price is above all the four direction lines, just hovering above magenta, cyan and yellow direction lines and reasonably above the white direction line. If it goes up from here, then it may give us a low risk long opportunity. The other industry that we intended to study was industrial conglomerates. It was weak for very long time, with some of the worst scores across many review periods, and now in recent periods it has turned cyan very fast. Right now it is one of the strongest industries. Let's look at the stocks in this industry. Using stock scorecard, we can filter for the stocks in industrial conglomerates. instantly from color coding we see only one stock is optimally valued, that is General Electric. Because the industry was lagging for a long time, we are going to look for optimal value stocks more than higher growth stocks, and GE is the only one. Pays a dividend of 3.3% now. Let's have a look at the stocks chart. This is GE using Hopon template. The chart looks very different from Marriott. Marriott was strong, and still we are going to look for a long trade in that stock based on its EPS growth. And General Electric declined a lot. It has poor growth, but it has optimal valuation. We are going to look for long trade in GE as well. These are two opposite kinds of trades. One is based on valuation, the other was based on growth. In General Electric, on the daily chart, we have a bullish headwind, and since then price went up. On Friday price gapped up, that was related to earnings. Amazing that the bullish headwind came just at the very bottom. There were several memory resistance lines at that time, so we'll probably not take any long trade at that time, but if we had short position we would protect them, and that would be a good idea. Soon after the bullish headwind came, from this candle onward all the memory resistances were broken. As of Friday, price has closed above three direction lines, magenta, cyan and yellow. If the stock starts to go up from here, or even better, if it pulls back little bit and starts to go up, then it may give us a low risk long trade opportunity. Interestingly, if we look at the weekly chart of GE, in the weekly backdrop chart, it had displayed bullish headwind again at the very bottom several weeks prior to the earnings day. In fact, 4 weeks before the earnings week, earnings was this last week, 3 weeks before that the bullish headwind had come. As of this week, the memory resistance in weekly is broken. The next memory resistance is far away. You may look for potential long opportunity in General Electric. It will be a bottom fishing opportunity, a low risk opportunity at the same time. All our trades are low risk trades. That is one constant in all our trades. Whether it was Marriott, where we were looking for trades based on growth, or GE, where we are looking for long trade based on valuation. Both are low risk trades. If it is not a low risk trade, then we don't want to take it. Let us look at the worst performing industries. These are the 10 worst performing industries of this week. The worst performers went down by much higher percentages, from about 2.9 to 14% down. Tobacco is the worst performer. It went down by more than 14%, and this stock Altria MO dropped by more than 10% this week. It had given a trend following go with flow short setup on daily chart on Wednesday 18th April, which has already given significant profit. Let's look at the tobacco industry, how it is changing in QH, and then look at Altria's technical charts. In QH, to look for the worst performing industries, we sort over primary 5 days period, smallest to largest. The worst performers come to the top. Tobacco is one of the worst performer now. It is worst performer now over many review periods. That probably happened because this week's drop was significant. If we look at the stock Altria, this is Altria ticker symbol MO using upon template. It was in downtrend with successive lower highs and lower lows. After the last low, it recovered, went to the value area, came to a place where the yellow direction line was also declining. On Wednesday, it gave us a magenta color candle. That's the entry signal for go with flow trend following short trade setup. At that time, the industry was also weakening. So combining the industry's weakness and the stock's technical weakness, we could take a short trade, put stop just above recent high entry at close of Wednesday's price and book profit at the lower boundary. Lower boundary was hit on Thursday, so we could book at least partial profit by Thursday. The industry is the worst performer. The chart is very bearish in daily. What about weekly chart? Weekly chart is also very bearish. It has a bearish shape and bearish color candle. Broke through multiple support watermark levels. Earlier it had broken all the support memory lines. This week's drop was on heavy activity in the weekly chart. Both on weekly as well as daily chart, MO is very bearish. The industry is the worst performer this week. Therefore, we would not book full profit on our short position. Partial position could be held with Q protection signal as stop loss. Let's see where is Q protection signal now on the daily chart. Our short entry signal came on this magenta color candle. Entry price was at this level. Stop was at this level. We can see how beautifully the Q protection signal allowed us to place stop safely away from entry price, but not very far. Therefore, we didn't have to risk much money in the trade. We had hit profit target on Thursday, lower boundary. We could book partial profit and the remaining position we could leave with a stop at the current protection level. Cyan color dots are the protection levels for short trade. So this is the level where we could put stop on remaining position, which is below our entry price. So even if the stop is hit on the remaining position also, we'll have nice profit. And if the stock continues to go down, then we will be able to let profit run. That is how, using industry's weakness as well as stock's weakness, we can decide when not to book full profit, like in case of MO. Semiconductors had been healthy for a long time. This week, semiconductor equipment industry became one of the worst performers. Is this a sign of worse times to come? We'll come back to that and study semiconductors more when we study the decelerating industries. Last week, six of the most decelerating industries were in consumer discretionary sector. They were decelerating. And this week, five of the worst performers are in the same sector, showing once again that QH industry score deceleration is one of the best predictors of impending weakness. Looking at the deceleration last week itself, I had mentioned that caution is warranted in the long positions in this sector, specifically in the industries that were strong earlier and starting to weaken. That was timely because many consumer discretionary sector industries are now among the worst performers. Specifically in the last market roundup, I had discussed these stocks, GCO, CATO and BKE, and mentioned while they were at the very top that we had to be cautious. Let us look at these three stocks and see how they turned out since last week. This is GCO, Genesco. since last week's warning, it has dropped slightly. Last week displayed a bearish headwind and it came to the memory resistance. There is a memory support in the weekly chart, so we may not take short trade right now. The memory support is in daily as well. However, the sector's weakness and the stock's weakness, the resistances in weekly and also the false upside breakout in daily, had led me to announce caution in this stock. So far, that is turning out to be a good idea. It's better not to look for any long trade in GCO right now. This is CATO, the second stock where I had mentioned caution last week. Last week's weekly candle shape was indecisive and daily had displayed a bearish headwind. Whenever the bearish headwind comes, we are cautious. There was no short trade setup, however, we would be protecting profit in any long position using Q protection signal. This week the stock moved sideways, neither did it go up or go down. The relative performance is showing that it is underperforming the market. So if we had long position, it was good idea to protect profit using Q protection stop. That stop was not hit, we can continue to maintain the stop. If it starts to roll over, it may give us a low risk short trade opportunity. Such an opportunity is not there yet, but it may come if the industry continues to weaken. This was the third stock related to apparel discussed in last market roundup, where I had warned of caution. Last week's candle shape in the weekly chart was bearish. It came and closed below the watermark resistance level, so that was a false upside breakout. This week it fell further. BKE also displayed a bearish headwind last week. So far, again, it is catching the very top. It is falling down from last week's market roundup. There is no low risk short trade opportunity right now. However, it was a good idea to start protecting profit in any long position. These three stocks illustrates how using Q 360 degrees analysis, which combines fundamentals, technicals, industry strength and weakness, we could be cautious ahead of time and protect profit in our long positions. Sometimes we may be able to take shorts at the very top or short at the first swing short opportunity, and in these cases we could protect profit in our long positions. Footwear is an industry that decelerated last week, and this week it is one of the worst performers. This stock Skechers dropped by more than 26% this week. This is earnings season, so stocks may have large move up or down. Skechers gave a possible box short setup on daily chart on this Wednesday before earnings. Seeing that, any long position holder could book their profit or protect profit using put options, or a short trader could take a short trade. As earnings was nearby, we would not like to short using stock, but we could short using short call verticals options position. That trade would be very profitable. Another stock, Netflix, has a very similar technical setup. That is why I had mentioned caution on Netflix through a post in our traders forum. We'll look at that shortly. Before that, let's look at the footwear industry and look at the specific stock Skechers. Footwear is having very low score right now over 5 days. It is magenta, that is, it is bearish, whereas earlier periods it was cyan. Clearly it was bullish and very nicely, smoothly transitioning from strength to weakness. Automatically, instantly it shows up on QH. It had started to weaken from several periods earlier. Looking at that, we could be cautious on any long positions. Sketchers had a very sharp drop in the weekly chart and of course in the daily chart that was associated with earnings. However, just before earnings, it had given us a possible box short trade setup on the daily chart. On this day, when the bear release signal had come, at that time price tried to go above the watermark resistance level that was in daily as well as in weekly, and there was heavy activity at the same level earlier, pointing to possible exhaustion, meaning there were bears coming in at that price level. That allowed us to take a short trade right at the close of this candle, Wednesday's candle. As earnings was nearby, we were not going to short with any stock trade, but we could short using short call vertical. That ended being a very profitable trade. And if we had a long stock position, which could be acquired long time ago, probably here, long-term investment in Sketchers. Remember, in market roundups of those periods, we had discussed Sketchers, we had discussed Nike, and we saw that though Nike was better known worldwide, Sketchers were better valued in terms of fundamentals. And in those days, we had discussed that if we had to take a long position, we would rather take that in Sketchers. So some of the long-term investors could be holding the position. For several weeks it was going sideways, and this week just before earnings it gave a potential box short trade setup. Looking at that, one could book profit or protect profit. Just before earnings it is not possible to protect profit using stop loss order. Instead, one could book profit or one could protect profit using put options, buying put options against the stock position one was holding. In either way, using the 360 degrees analysis, looking at the industry's weakness and then looking at the technical trade setup, one could either take a profitable short trade or protect profit in one's long position. Let's look at the chart of Netflix. It is having a chart similar to that of Sketchers, and I shared it in the traders forum. This is the posting in our community 3 days ago, caution on Netflix long position. And I could post it while Netflix was at the very top in the market, in the media, people are very bullish, and Netflix is a strong stock. However, there are some warning signals, not very different from what was in Sketchers. Sketchers was also a very strong stock. When I shared the post in community, Netflix had gone up at that time with a gap up here that was associated with earnings. After earnings, it gapped up and came precisely to the level of the watermark resistance where bearish headwind had come earlier. Seeing that, I had mentioned caution and told that if somebody is holding long position, they may be cautious, protect profit using Q protection signal stop loss order or look for potential short opportunity. Is Netflix fundamentals? We can look it up from scorecard in 1 minute. as we know the ticker symbol, we can simply filter for that NFLX. In terms of valuation, it is very poorly valued, overvalued. In terms of growth, it has very robust growth. If we look at the quarterly growths more closely, we'll see that the latest quarterly growth was smaller than previous quarter's growth. So growth is still there, but growth slowed down a little bit. It is certainly overvalued. This is Netflix using at a glance template. We can see at earnings it gapped up, hit precisely the watermark resistance level. That is the time when I told people to be cautious, and since then it pulled down a little bit. In the daily chart, it has given a bear release signal. It has created a false upside breakout. Therefore, in daily chart, it is meeting all the requirements of a box short trade setup. In weekly, it tried to go above the watermark resistance and reversed. It has created a false upside breakout there as well. The weekly candle color is still cyan, so the weekly checklist condition for box short trade setup is not met. One may or may not take a short trade because all the checklist conditions are not met. The one on weekly is not met. However, it is looking neither weak nor strong, but it may fall down because that is the price level from where price has declined heavily and there were heavy selling at that same price level. So the long position holders could protect their profit using stop loss. As earnings has already passed, it is possible to protect profit using stop order. One do not need to buy puts for protecting their long position. Accelerating industries. Every week we study the accelerating industries because they tend to be the best performing industries in subsequent weeks. While we are studying this, we may keep in mind that the market is neutral to bearish. Not bullish, not bearish also, but becoming less bullish now. So we'll be cautious about taking any long trade. At the same time, we may look for long trades in defensive industries. We have three of the accelerating industries that were weak earlier: airlines, water utilities, and alternative carriers. We will look at QH shortly, and that will instantly show that these three industries are nicely transitioning from weakness to strength. And CenturyLink, well-known stock, we have mentioned it many times in the market roundups. It was optimally valued and it continues to be optimally valued. It may give us a breakout long opportunity next week, and it is expected that the daily flow candle color will also turn cyan, bullish at the same time. Water utilities is one industry that accelerated. In fact, if we drill down into utilities sector, we'll see many of the utilities industries accelerated this way. So you may look for potential longs, not only water utilities, but other utilities as well. Let's look at alternative carriers and the utilities industries after that. In QH, to look for the accelerating industries, we can sort over page 5 days column, largest to smallest. The most accelerating industries come to the top. We are always looking for transition from magenta to cyan or cyan to magenta. We can see that clearly in airlines, water utilities, and alternative carriers. All were magenta earlier and this week turned cyan with acceleration. The score over 5 days is cyan, so they are already bullish, and base 5 days is cyan, showing that they became bullish with acceleration. In alternative carriers, we have this stock Century Link, we discussed many times. Let's look up its fundamentals. These are the stocks in alternative carriers industry. Instantly from the color coding, we see only one stock is optimally valued. As the industry was weak for a long time, we are not going to look for high growth stocks, but we are going to look for optimal value stocks. Remember, first when we started discussing Century Link, it had dividend yield of more than 14%. Now it is up little bit, still it gives a very high dividend yield of 12% plus. Let's look at its technical charts. We started discussing Century Link at the very bottom when the bullish headwind had appeared. Then price went up, more or less moving sideways in the weekly chart for many weeks, up, down, up. This week it broke above the resistance in weekly. In daily, looking from the right side, we see it is moving somewhat sideways, up, down, up, down. Several memory resistance lines were there earlier, all those were broken, but one is still there. And there is a nearby watermark resistance level. If price breaks above this watermark resistance next week, I am expecting that the candle color will also turn cyan. That may give us a low risk breakout trade. Usually Q traders don't like to take breakout trades except when they result in low risk entry opportunities. This may be one such case. Water utilities accelerated, and I mentioned several other utilities accelerated as well. Let's look it up from QH. We can go to QH sector analysis, go to the utilities row and click on the drill down button. That will bring all the utilities industries in the industry panel. We can see all the utilities industries accelerated heavily this week. Some of them were already strong. Water utilities was strong earlier, declined little bit and now regained strength. And some like multi utilities was relatively weaker. You can see the 5-day score is still magenta, but the acceleration column, the past 5 days column in cyan, is telling us that it is starting to turn around. That is how the acceleration column can tell us what is probably going to happen next week. We see that it is pretty accurate and it is useful to pay attention to these acceleration codes. As all the utilities industries accelerated, it is probably a good idea to start looking for low risk long opportunities. I didn't have time to do that, but you may do the drill down either using QH or using stock scorecard. Let's now move to decelerating industries. Six of the worst decelerating industries are in Infotech. And we saw from sector analysis that from last week's very large gain, Infotech sector refers to a small loss this week. That sector reversal, along with so many decelerating industries coming in Infotech, further strengthens our thought to be cautious in this sector. Two of the worst decelerating industries are in semiconductors. Semiconductor equipment industry. In fact, if we look at QH, we'll see all the semiconductor industries decelerated. These were strong for a long time. Now is probably the time to book profit on longer term long positions, and if one wants to continue to hold some position, it is best to use stop to protect profit and also look for potential shorts. Gold mining is one industry that decelerated. During the commodities analysis of GLD ETF, I had mentioned that though gold ETF was moving sideways, gold miners were going up, and now it has started displaying deceleration. That is a good reason probably to start booking profit on remaining long positions. We had discussed these two stocks earlier, Newmont and Royal Gold. It will be a good idea to book full profit or protect profit in remaining position using stop. Let's look at the Q charts for Newmont and Royal Gold. We had started discussing possible long position in Newmont several weeks ago, and since then it went up nicely. At the right edge, it came very close to the watermark resistance in daily, where bearish headwind had come earlier, and now another bearish headwind has come in the daily chart. In weekly also, it came to the very long term watermark resistance level. Bear release signal has also appeared. There was heavy activity at the same price level earlier, showing that bears came in aggressively at the same price level. At the right edge, it is showing several weaknesses, possible reversal from watermark resistance, bear release signal, bearish headwind signal, and the industry decelerated. So it would be a good idea to either book profit or at least protect profit using Q protection stop loss. The other stock in gold mining that we discussed earlier for possible long position was Royal Gold. Royal Gold came to the watermark resistance in daily, reversed from there with bear release signals that created a false upside breakout. In weekly also, it came to the watermark resistance level and reversed from there, again creating a false upside breakout. Price is supported by memory support line, so if somebody is holding long position, it is not necessary to book profit yet. However, as the industry decelerated and it is at watermark resistance level and created false upside breakout, it is good idea to protect profit using protection signal, protection stop. That is how, using Q charts and Q industry analysis, we can identify longs at the right time, book partial profit, and also be cautious on the remaining position, being careful not to let the profit erode. The Q charts and the industry deceleration industry scores provides clear guidance on when to enter, when to book profit, and when to protect profit. Let me summarize. The broad market indices and market breadth study shows that though the markets went up this week, under the hood there was weakness all around. New high lows, advance decline, up down volume, everything declined. That shows clear weakness under the hood. The ETFs are not showing that weakness. The candle shapes in weeklies are all very bearish. However, there is no swing short opportunity in any of the ETFs. And some of the ETFs weekly candle colors continue to remain bullish. In such a market, it is probably better to stay away from taking any swing trades. When we started looking for potential trades, we saw it is not easy to find low risk trade opportunities right now, like was the case for past several weeks. At the same time, when we ran the newly designed sonar for breakouts, we see many more stocks are breaking out. They are not giving low risk entry opportunity right now, but many more stocks are breaking down than breaking up. That also shows that the market is turning bearish. We may be cautious about our long positions, protect profit. If there is earnings and the weekly charts and daily charts are showing weakness, it may be better to close positions or protect them using put option and look for low risk short opportunities. we saw some of such short opportunities that came last week, like in Skechers, but not many. We may wait for more clear trend in the broad market before starting to take many swing trades. That was all that I wanted to share in today's session. Thank you for attending. I look forward to seeing you in the next session. Have a great weekend and trade profitably.